Welcome to my tutorial today. My name is Oidaka, a technical trainer in the engineering unit. Today I will be showing you how to construct an ellipse when you are given a number of conditions. Again, two conditions, the major diameter and the minor diameter, or basically what is also known as major and minor axis. And we'll be using Foci method to construct the ellipse. For this case, our major axis AB is 120 millimeters and our minor axis CD is 80 millimeters. So the first thing is to draw the two diameters, diameter AB to denote the major axis and minor axis CD, which is equivalent to 80 millimeters. So AB is equivalent to 120 millimeters and CD is equivalent to 80 millimeters. And the two diameters, the two axes, should interact at an angle of 90 degrees through the center. Once we have the two diameters, then the next thing is to establish focus point 1 and focus point 2. Remember, you are using the Foci method, so we need to establish F1 and F2 to denote focus 1 and focus 2. And for us to do that, we will open our compass to half the radius equivalent to half the major diameter. And for this case, our major diameter A is AB, so we will open our compass to radius equivalent to half the major diameter. And then using point C as our center, we describe an arc on the major diameter to denote F1 and F2. Therefore, once we have those two points, then we need to establish a number of other points from F1. We could still call this point O. F1O, we define and we establish a number of points. For the case of ease of following up, we'll do points at a distance of 5 millimeters from F1. So we get point 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then we do the same on the other part from F2, we also define another 4 points using 5 millimeter. Then we get point 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then once we have established those points, then we will, they are the ones that will help us to define the path that is made by this ellipse, or the locus of a point that is defined by these diameters, of course using the Foci method. So with our compass, we will open our compass to radius A1. Radius A1, then using F as the center, we describe an arc above and below the major axis. Then we'll get radius B1. We'll get radius B1. And then using F2 as the center, we describe other arcs to cut the previous one that we've made with radius A1. So again, we repeat the same process. We'll get radius A2. Then using F1 as the center, we describe an arc above and below. Then we get radius 2B. then using F2 as the center, we describe another arc to cut the previous one. We do the same with point 3 and point 4. That will establish the points that we require on the left hand side of our minor diameter to complete the required ellipse. So we've already generated our points on the left hand side of our minor diameter to define the points that will give us the locus of our points to define the ellipse on the left hand side of our minor diameter. So we do the same with the right hand side of the minor diameter to get the other points that will complete the ellipse. So for this case, we will use the same process but on the right hand side. So we get distance B1, then using F2 as the center, describe an arc above and below. We get radius A1 on the right hand side of the minor diameter, and then using F1 as the center, describe an arc above and below to cut the previous one. Then we get distance B2 using F2 as the center, describe an arc above and below. Then we get radius A2, F1 as the center, describe arcs to cut the previous ones, and then we do the same to point 3 and 4. Those are the points that will define our ellipse, of course using the Foci method. Then what remains is to join the points with a smooth curve, and of course point A, B and C will also form part of, will also form points around the required ellipse. There we are. This is the ellipse that we're looking for. Of course, we've used the Foci method. I want to thank you for staying tuned, for following me up with this construction of ellipse using Foci method. I want to welcome you to leave your comments in our comment section. Tell us any other areas that you wish us to focus on. But of course, I wish you, and I want you to share and continue learning with our tutorials. Let us know other areas that you wish us to focus on. But of course, like our channel and subscribe to our channel, The Technique.